such tracing and tracking systems, we just simply undercalculate the processes within agriculture. So once again, this particular statement is just in conjunction to identify the inevitable importance of the system to be developed. Well, I think you more or less know that, for example, the cadastre system which exists in the country, for the moment it comprises only geographic and legal aspects, so the ownership aspects of the land tenure, and only 20-30% of the existing land resources are registered in this country. So there's a huge gap that we are experiencing. I just want to mention, for example, the titanic work that has been done by the Program Management Agency during planning of the direct subsidy schemes for the plowing, so the plowing program. And they had, in 3 months actually, they have made the inventory of the holdings. And then lately the agricultural census has proved the accuracy of the data that APMA has gathered. But still, there is much to be done in this particular regard to have the system formalized. This is not a critic, this is just a reality that we are facing. And when we identify a reality, it's also a way out that we can identify through it. Some words on the relevance. So, as you're probably aware, the separated chapter in the associated agreement between Georgia and EU stipulates the agriculture and rural development. There is no direct stipulation of farm register or any register, but there's a very interesting stipulation. And if you look down to this slide, the Article 349 stipulates that two parties who undersign the associate agreement, they will pledge their effort to reduce the informal economy and informal employment. So towards fulfilling this priority, this is the system that will provide a very powerful incentives for that. What about the government strategy? Well, this is very general, let's say, umbrella of the strategic frame, so I will not stop so much on this. On the part of the farmers register issue, there are four sub-priorities that is very clearly defined within the strategy framework document. So, first one is improving governance of land resources. Second, developing agricultural cadastre. Third, introduction of modern geoinformation systems for land registry and land tenure. And improving the related legislative and regulatory base. This is stipulated by the strategy. And the strategy directly envisions that the land use and GIS systems will be developed, and it has a very straight reference to the existing EU LPIS systems. So the strategy says clearly that we should replicate LPIS system which exists in the EU countries. And one of the examples we just witnessed through the presentation of our Polish expert. At the same time, we should also say that the frame document is one part of the strategy, and I should say that strategically it's very well defined. At the same time, we still need to improve the action plan, which does not help so much to implement these pledges from the frame document. What we have is that in the action plan, we have a special commitment on the vineyard registry, which is a very important part of the entire system, although it's not a full part of it, just a part of it. And I should also mention that quite a sound technical system has been provided by FAO in this registration process in our local district. That has provided very important insights for future planning. Just imagine, not only from the general point of view, but also very, very detailed technical point of view. You can even find the chronometrage of the processes within the FAO report. So I think it's very important that this report is taken as a kind of basis for further action in this regard. So some words on the experiences. I will not take much of your time on this because we have already listened very detailed, concrete country experience in this regard. So European legal basis to create farmer register is established on the basis of the Article 68 of EU Regulation Number 1306. And there are two integrated mandatory requirements for each member country under this regulation, which is first, identification system for the agricultural parcel, meaning LPIS, and second, a single system to record the identity of each beneficiary of support for any common agricultural policy scheme measures who submits an aid application or a payment claim, meaning that this system is needed to identify the right beneficiaries for the agricultural subsidies. And I will not expand and amplify much on these sub-regulations, just simply saying that, for example, there's a very diverse sub-regulations that are explaining the principles of the registration, identification of farmer, areas and animal data, investment measures, as well as identification of the beneficiary. Well, actually, as we are on the way of synchronizing to the system, we should take into consideration this particular phase. One principal conclusion on the new experience is that the main purpose of all the registration of farmers in a single system is based on the requirement to uniquely identify each beneficiary of agricultural, European agricultural subsidies, and to ensure that aid goes to the right person or holding. And there is a broader sense, the data registered or linked to a farm can be also used to assess the farm eligibility to state support on the one hand, through GIS, graphical system control, and namely the land parcel identification system. Actually, the land parcel identification system has come to an effect in 1992, already when, and it is directly linked to the introduction of the common agricultural policy of the European Union. And lately, it was containing only agricultural lands. But lately, just in conjunction to adoption of the Agenda 2000 and the transformation of the common agricultural policy with enriching elements of rural development, as well as environmental elements, this LPIS has been enriched. And I think we saw a very good example of this multifaceted system that Poland is maintaining that contains not only agricultural holdings or parcels, but also animal registry, also environmental elements, as well as motorways, water resources, and so on. So this is an integrated, holistic, so to say, system. So just some words on the certain differences in between LPIS, land parcel identification, and the cadaster. So why cadaster is not enough? Because the cadaster treats the ownership of the land. But it does not concentrate on the land tenure, on the land use. Well, actually, from the cadaster you get an information about the owner, but you cannot get an information on the land use and on the holding character. So it will not give you an information to plan the policies in support to the holdings. It just gives you an information who owns what and how much. So actually, the agricultural parcel is a continuous piece of land with a single crop cultivated by a single farmer. This is the subject of the land parcel identification system. And it was very important that this is not the case for every EU member country. There are differences. For example, in Spain, it's different. It's different. In Poland, the fact is that the Poland is relatively new member of the EU, and this issue has been covered in parallel. So the canister system, the LPIS system, has been developed in parallel, and it had enriched each other. So I think for us it's quite an interesting lesson to maintain. In addition, generally speaking, the system is based on the following technical pillars, and I think it has been explained, so I will just quickly outline this. It is based on the large-scale topographic mapping on the one side, and secondly, it is based on the ortho imagery photos. Well, some conclusions. So once again, I want to reiterate that we are investing much in agriculture, but we have poor means to measure the impact. And one of the gaps is once again this, that this system needs to be developed. And I think you have observed from the presentation of Aneta what would be the benefits. The benefits would be two-faced. This will be benefit for the state, because the state acquires the tool for the efficient policy planning on the one hand, and secondly, indirectly, it also gives a very positive impact on the development of the land market. Because as we have observed, for example, the introduction of such system and its work during the last decade has brought about the consolidation of holdings, consolidation of the land parcels, decrease of holdings, and increase of land prices. This is due because this system is interlinked to the subsidy scheme on the one side, and on the other side, it is interlinked to the land market conjecture. So, another conclusion is that for the moment, we have only 20-30% of our land resources registered, which is a great gap and should be fulfilled in the nearest future. I would envision in the frame of the existing strategy, which is up to 2020. So, as I have mentioned in the relevance chapter to the association agreement, despite of tax exemption on the primary production, formalizing agricultural smallholder sector is an absolute priority and even a must under the association agreement, especially Article 349. And this is primarily needed for programmatic planning of necessary support measures, as well as for developing monitoring systems to measure the impact of state support interventions. So for this purpose, the strategy already identifies two areas that require immediate solution: tackling land registration problems and developing the LPIS. We all know, whoever works in agriculture, how conservative and paranoidly reluctant are farmers to issue the transparent information about their holdings, because they are afraid that they will be taxed or something like that. I think I have a lot of confidence in this hall. We always face the problem to retrieve the information. So how do we motivate them to issue the right information about their holding? Simply to interlink this system with the subsidy scheme. If you are the farmer and you think that you are eligible for the state support, so please take the time and think that you should be registered. Otherwise, you will not be a subject of the state support. As simple as that. And this is the case that we should also take as an example. So one thing: introduction of direct subsidies for land registration. This is also a very I think it's a very important recommendation, because currently, as we are dealing, as a majority of farmers are at the edge of poverty, they are either not, it is not affordable for the majority of them to pay for the land registration fee. So this would be also additional motivating point if the state will think about, because to the best of my knowledge, Ministry of Economy already initiated the process of talking with eligible to be subsidized as an agricultural holding. So another recommendation is about that the implementation of farmer register should focus on the enhancement of agricultural data through improved information communication processes that requires adoption of innovative means in the information and communication technologies, where there are two basic elements, alphanumeric and graphical. And this has been demonstrated by Annette here. So there is a combination of alphanumeric data, which is data on farmers' holdings and so on the one side, and the graphical that visualizes the maps, orthophoto imagery. And it should be a part of one system. And it should be primarily focused on supporting the agricultural policy and to manage and control subsidies. Some words about the agricultural program management agency. This agency, by its existing mandate, what it's doing, actually it more or less replicates the payment agencies in any EU member state. The existing subsidy schemes are channeled through this agency. So this is absolutely natural that this agency will be officially mandated to administer this system, because it already implements certain elements of it. And it should be a coordinator of implementing the activities in this particular regard. In order to support the data collection process, appropriate institutional structures have to be in place. Besides the network of local offices, it is also recommended that the Ministry of Agriculture delegates tasks to APMA for the process of data collection, registration and maintenance of LPIS and farm register. So, following responsibilities are recommended here that APMA will be delegated for. So this is daily monitoring of the software components and the maintenance of contact with providers of software solutions, plus maintenance of databases themselves, preparation of methodology data collection, preparation of manuals for the farmers, and I think good examples have been demonstrated here, quality control of input data, setup of quality assurance of databases, planning and preparation of technical specifications for the future software upgrades, supervision of the regional branch staff. I think it's also a separated issue. We have seen here that Poland has started from 8,500 offices because it was paper-based. But step by step, when the process was digitalized and computerized, you are now in the regional offices, you have 510 staff, right? 360 plus 150.
No, in the agency we have, in all agency, in all Poland we have now 10,000 people.
Still,
because we have a lot of work, different work, not only for controls. Yeah, still we have.
Well, this figure is not encouraging, especially for Georgia. It identifies the need.
Many countries like
this. Is a hell of a paperwork. And so you have mentioned 40 million documents. Well, this is Poland. Well, Georgia is four times less, but still 10 million documents.
But we have no internet connection in some regions.
Yeah, so that's a complex problem. It also has individual infrastructure with all these.
Yeah, it's a challenge, but it's possible to do it.
Yeah, provision of various forms of support to local office staff. I think also the principal decision on the on equipping APMA, if the responsibility is delegated to have the local offices or local branches and so on, still underway, it should be decided. And this is absolutely needed. So maybe we can link it to the existing extension offices on the municipal level that exists in the ministry. This could be just enriching with one or two couple of staff or something like that. So all of these things, I should say also that FAO also has concentrated on this issue. So you can find more detailed, even more specific, more technical recommendations in this regard. Also, performance of required data analysis. Since having such tools, I think it's a natural responsibility that APMA can be equipped with as well. Well, some other, for example, it's very interesting that FAO has calculated how much time and how many people will be required just to start registration to accomplish the first wave of registration. Well, the calculation is 7 farmers per consultant per day. This is the daily speed of registration. And it was grounded on the process that has been conducted in Angola, as well as the other countries like Croatia, Macedonia, Turkey, and Azerbaijan. So 7 farmers per consultant per day. Meaning that in case of 700,000 holdings that we are dealing with, this will take, I have a figure somewhere, I think it's 420 people. 420 registration officers to tackle 700,000 holdings in 1 year. So it is a recommendation of FAO to conduct kind of a nationwide campaign starting from 1st of January ending to 31st of December, engaging 420 enumerators that can tackle 700,000 households. Very challenging job, but realistic, quite realistic, but it's a hell of a job. Another recommendation, I think we have got very good evidence from Poland, integration of farm registry with animal registry, as well as integration with the vineyard registry. So additional data maintained within the farm registry should be further discussed with the National Wine Agency, because it has already developed a very serious strains, as well as auto-injury base, as well as alphanumerical data. So this should be done in a very close coordination in between APMA, wine agency, Geostat, as well as state registry, national registry. And last but not least, all this should be framed and based on a certain legislation. So there's a need to draft the law for the registration of farmers in Georgia, because we have the gap on the level of the registration. So it's a direct recommendation, as well as it's a recommendation of FAO. So what should this law contain? It should draft the principle that should contain two main definitions to create farmer register: farmer and agricultural activities. We have very rich definition of agricultural activity that you can find in the entrepreneurial code, as well as law on agricultural cooperatives. Well, this exists, but what we do not have the definition of farmer. So at the same time, we're tackling the issue of the farmer status by developing this system. And this should be stipulated in the law, as well as rights of entering the farmer register of lands, for example. And AETA has amplified on this that not all have right to enter this, so who is eligible to use the data from this, as well as determination of the location for the data entry, as well as the elements that each farmer shall be registered, and also is established the administrative process for the deletion of the farmer from the register. This should be also taken into the consideration, because to be registered in this system is a voluntary act from the side of the farmer. The only thing is that it indirectly motivated, the linkage to the subsidy scheme indirectly motivated the farmer to register. Otherwise, it's a voluntary act. So there should be a stipulation in case a farmer expresses the will to be deleted from this system. The role of the government on the national level, as well as the centralized offices, specific powers, responsibilities, in addition to the roles of different ministries and agencies, state agencies in Georgia, that may participate in exchanging data in order to create an integrated data agriculture system. So you saw Ministry of Environment, the state, the state department for the motorways or something like that. So all these depository agencies should come together, as well as the elements of data access, transparency, privacy, and supervision. So thank you very much indeed for your attention. I hope I haven't taken much of your time. You can still find very detailed and specific recommendations in FAO report, FAO report as well. And I do hope that 2017 can play a role in the planning year for the process. And if we start the process in 2018, we can still afford to have something in place for the end of the frame of the strategy, which is 2020. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It was really very interesting presentation, and it's really on the agenda of the government and of the Ministry of Agriculture towards the farm register system. So with this, I would like to suggest you to proceed with the next item of the agenda, to open discussions, and I would like to ask you, the audience, could we please this discussion in Georgian, maybe it could be more comfortable, and our colleague from Learning for the Foundation for translation for
Ще да е възможността, 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 ще да е възможността,
showing you the shower on the left.
And now it's on the bottom of the product. The product is called Business as Rush. And it's as well, OBS, you do run informations, on the request.
Thank you.
So, agriculture market agency has own database, and now we try to build one agency with agriculture market agency plus my agency, but we have a problem with the data of the farmers, because we have our own good system for producer register and data of the address and etc. They don't have this number, so when we try to compare and combine everything, we have a big problem. So even if you decide the system for identification and the registration of animals will be under the other institution, and this register of agricultural land and etc. will be under the other, you have to remember about connection. So the producer number and the address and geographic coordinates are very, very important. Not only for land register purposes, and but this is very important for animal health and breeding diseases, because it's easy to catch the moment when you have a problem. And if you have the geographical coordinates and the producer number, it's easy to cycle the zones and restricted areas. So remember about this.
We are considering this issue. This identification and registration of animals will remain under the national food agency, but our agricultural project management agency will have access on their database, and they can just use the information collected there. That's just.
Yeah, but if you have a producer number or something like this now in this animal registration system?
Yeah, we have also
any identification number.
Okay, so you should use the same number in your producer register system. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much. Terrible. Yeah. Maximum, care, dacă lungă, viitoare strântă, este un șeo, dacă a dat amași. Dar mai șeo de să fiu, are respință, registrele, cum nu, să fie respință. Scoate scoase arbitrie, deschide. O? Anua care se ogeate supleva, luăm toate pe forma și ogeate răzutoare ca în acum amază, tot să nu țărea, care eu pot să vedem, când vrei să nu știu, și vrem să nu să da să șeră, e să rechită, vreau nu vreau ce să. E de la asta, dar în felul sopăl și ce în vor situația să adăți să ogeate țară, vorbesc, vă pot să fac caos. Anua, pot să nu ți-o cum ar spune. Da, cei de vreme cont de timpizată, din am clasat risi, s-a putut face potențial ce e nevoie să fie pe tot permanent. Mai vrea mai mult, dar nu ne-am nimic, nu le am permanent. Am și-am fost și la scopul. Vreau să facă de timp și-am fost și vreau să-ți plec, mă apel să-ți spun să-mi vă rog, dar ce vă dați acolo. Și eu îți spun, mi-ți agarbi, 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 că de vas, pe care vă mai bine, mult că mi-i și-ți horos. I s-a întâmplat, dar nu
Thank you.
cesta, pracą mamy sypu salonie, hausy, kiedy mi z niego śpiewa, to jest akacki twarz, pewnie nie było tak, a moje sary jest ty tema, a cały mi się kamy do głowa, moje sary jest ty kamy do głowa. Dajmy,
ale to się nie było i się okazał na niego szkole, to się odczycili na tu ramię gadało, tak jak to, o, kolega, wieszki, dalej tam nie było, to
się odczycili. O, dziękuję,
tam już sobie chcę, bo to am proces și ți-a înregistrație sistemă și în celălalt și în intervalul și pe locul scop. Și ce-a zis să ai gândit un mai jos, un chat-ul, o mere, arăt mă ce destru, este un înțeleg scriu. Este un înțeleg că are restul copilină, m-am spus să ajungă pe care, dar ar trebui să scrie să ajungă tot, am atât de timp în intervalul și am ușor.
Am văzut că nu am ușor, să am ușor de pe ușor de bani,
your check